Dire predictions today from some of the nation's foremost terrorism experts. It was a practical yet often ominous view of where we stand in finding and fighting terrorists.
This is not a skirmish. This is a major war, and it may well last not years but decades.
From special forces units to stopping the flow of money, this group of leading terrorism experts addressed what can be done and what needs to be done.
The first is to disrupt the infrastructure of this group. Clearly, that goes to not just the conventional communications of telephones, satellite phones, disrupting that, turning that off, but now it's going to require some efforts over the use of the internet, because clearly they've been doing that.
The important thing in this, I think, is allies, allies, and allies.
This panel, assembled by the Defense Week publication, agreed that capturing Osama bin Laden is only a beginning, in many ways symbolic.
If the Taliban tomorrow show up and offer bin Laden's head on a platter, that has not ended the problem.
In the big picture, the greatest fear among them is biological and chemical warfare.
We are still not prepared across the country. We don't stockpile, as Jim said, appropriate vaccines. We don't stockpile the antibiotics that we need.
The former director of the CIA says success in finding and combating terrorist cells will have to rely on effective espionage.
Anybody who thinks you can penetrate terrorist groups any other way, wake up. That's the way you get information from terrorist groups, is by finding members of them who are willing, for their own reasons, whatever, to give you information in exchange for something. That is called espionage.
On the home front, Livingston points to a list of fugitives, names and addresses of people he believes could be intent on more violence and destruction.
It may be the B team and the C team. Here already a sleeper is ready to carry out additional terrorist attacks the moment that we let down our guard.
Livingston believes rescinding the ban on assassinations is necessary. None on that panel could predict when or if bin Laden might be captured, or if he was still in Afghanistan.